We need 23 seats to win back the House.
Deborah Holland is running for Congress. She's the Democratic nominee in New Mexico's 1st Congressional District, hoping to make history by becoming the first Native American woman to serve on Capitol Hill.
If there's any chance that you'd be willing to make another generous donation.
But as all political candidates know, running a campaign takes money, especially for first-time contenders.
It's no secret that you have to raise a lot of money to run a congressional campaign because you really do have to have ads on TV, and TV is expensive.
I'm Deb Holland.
Holland is funding her campaign with lots of small donations coming through the internet, regular mail, and at fundraising events like this one.
I have a lot of donors who will donate $3, $5, $10 apiece. And I'm the Democratic nominee for Congress in New Mexico.
Her most powerful fundraising tool, she says, is her telephone.
Thank you so much. You have a wonderful evening. I have called some people who have said I've never, ever been called by a candidate. Thank you for calling me. I'm so happy to hear from you.
Deb Holland, I'm well. Hi, Phil. Nice to see you.
Since Holland doesn't accept money from corporate political action committees, she also relies on contributions from Native American tribes and through Democratic fundraisers like Emily's List that collect money from individual donors who are interested in a specific issue. Sarah Briner is research director for the Center for Responsive Politics in Washington.
A lot of people who donate to women candidates are interested in getting more women in office, but they're also interested in the policy positions that women politicians tend to hold, particularly things like abortion and other sort of what we might consider traditional women's issues.
Briner emphasizes that most of the campaign donations to women this year are going to Democrats.
This particular cycle, we're seeing the breakdown more along party lines, with Republicans getting less money, Republican women getting practically nothing, and Democrats getting more money from individual donors.
My name is Ami Hober, and I'm running for Congress.
Oh, okay.
But that hasn't stopped Ami Hober, who is also in a contest for a seat in Congress.
Ever since, I've just rolled up my sleeves to get the job done.
After losing to a Democrat in 2016, she's running again as a Republican candidate for Maryland's 6th Congressional District that spans a large part of Northwest Maryland. She's financing her campaign with small and large donations, as well as personal contributions from herself and her husband, Mark Epstein.
Last time I was unknown. I had to prove myself, and at this point, I think I've proven myself very well. And people know that I am willing to put my own resources on the line because I believe in what I'm doing.
Hello, Beverly. My name is Ami Hober.
Hober believes it's harder for female candidates to ask for donations.
It was hard for me to learn how to ask a complete stranger on the phone to help donate to the campaign. But I'm much more comfortable with it this cycle than I was last cycle.
How are you? Good to see you again.
As the political contenders head into their final days of campaigning, they hope to prove that in America, reaching your political goals is possible as long as you have the money to help you win.
All you guys vote for me now.
Julie Taboh, VOA News, Frederick, Maryland.